Going on, guys. Welcome, Rabid here, and it is time for me to build my most powerful and efficient CPU mining rig I have ever built. So it has been a long time coming, probably about 3.5-4 years. You guys all know that's been following the channel. I've been dreaming about a dual EPYC build for pretty much ever when it comes to CPU mining. So right here, what we got is two EPYC CPUs. They are the EPYC 7742. So each CPU is 64 core, 128 threads, and 256 megabytes of L3 cache. So this entire rig as one, two CPUs on one motherboard, is 128 cores, 256 threads, and 512 megabytes of L3 cache. So we'll be able to utilize these full CPUs for CPU mining. So what's going on here is RandomX algorithm, which is your Monero, your Zeph, your Yattacoin, anything that runs on RandomX. Now there is a RandomX V2 that's potentially coming soon to kind of hinder the Bitmain X5 and boost the hash rate of AMD Ryzen CPU. So we got to keep that in mind as well. But right now, everything should still work as is. So that's RandomX for those coins. And then we also got Ghost Rider, which requires 2 megabytes of L3 cache per thread as well. So we can fully utilize. Now the exception is Haven. Haven does require 4 megabytes per thread. So we'd only be able to utilize half this system. You need so much L3 for that. But I do believe GPUs are probably better on it at this point anyway. And then when it comes to Virus Coin and stuff, it doesn't really matter about the L3 cache. So Intels and stuff go there. But this is the main reason why Intels really do suck when it comes to CPU mining, is they just don't have the L3 cache, and these definitely do. So I do have this all standing up here, hanging out, as you can see on the stands. If you guys, yeah, you can kind of see under there. So it's all on the stands. Here's the coolers right here. So I am going to situate the coolers, I think, with the fans facing each other right here. That way it sucks out of the middle here and kind of blows outwards. Hopefully that works. If I start getting overheating issues, you know, in the future, I'm probably going to have to change it up because we don't want these to overheat. But that's the first setup I'm going to try. So before we get into that, though, I did have to look in a previous video on how I did the thermal paste on my single build here, because I do have a previous EPYC 7742 rig build. I tested that out and got hash rates across multiple coins. We're going to do that with this one and compare it and see, you know, is it more efficient running two CPUs on one motherboard, or is you better off running one at a time and so on. So we're going to see what happens there in the future when we do testing here. This is just a build video. But here I went over the thermal paste job, and for a second I was thinking I had to put an outline around it and then an X. And good thing I looked at it. My past video, I was too lazy to look up AMD again, so I went through my past video there, and I actually have to make an X and then a dot in between each X, because there's a bunch of chips all around it and some kind of in the middle. So this is a huge CPU and it does use a lot of thermal paste. Luckily, I do have this big bad boy 10 gram worth of Noctua thermal paste right here. I just ordered the other day, not sponsored in any way, shape or form. But if you are looking for thermal paste, you always want to have extra, because you never want to run out of this stuff in case you have a job to do. So check them links down in the description. So the first thing I did, I already flashed HiveOS onto the NVMe drive. This does not use an M2 SSD. It will not detect it, unless this one will, but I know my other EPYC did not. So you do have to use an NVMe drive. So I'm going to do these one at a time. Let's start with this first CPU and do some thermal paste here. So again, we're going to do the X and then the dot. So hopefully I do. There's supposed to be a point on this thing. It's really hard to see where I'm coming from here, but you know what? Let's just see how this goes. Now, my last job was definitely a big butcher job. Hopefully this isn't as bad, but it's already looking like it might be. All right, let's go. Oh, I can feel this. We're using so much. All right. Oh, little glitch there. Now we're going to come in the other way, do the nice little X. Lift it up a bit. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Awesome. And now we're going to want a dot in between each one, kind of like so. Oh, this is looking a little better than my last one. Hopefully those dots aren't too big. There we go. Something like that. So that's not too bad, but I guess we'll see what happens if this baby overheats or not. Now, before we put this cooler in, I kind of want to show you exactly kind of how these go. As you can see here, there's two kind of inside right here and two on the outside. So this is a lot wider apart than this one here. And if you look here, you can actually adjust these. If you loosen them off, you can slide them in and out if you want to spin this around or whatever. But right now it's kind of set up with two inside. You can see they're closer together and these ones are on the outside. So that's kind of how, actually, never mind. These aren't on the outside, these are on the inside. So I'm actually gonna have to adjust this to get them to the outside to fit on there. So give me a second. All right, so that was pretty simple. Now you can see those are on the outside and these are on the inside. So now I'm gonna slap this on and hopefully we don't wreck anything. You know, that's always the famous last words. I should probably also figure out where exactly, actually we should have enough cable for anywhere. So I'm gonna put this on and hopefully we have enough cable there to reach. So get this situated within the holes I think we're in. Now I gotta kinda tighten these down. Okay, so there we have everything kinda tightened down nice and evenly. Now you're supposed to have a torque wrench when, or a torque screwdriver, a torque something, when installing these, as well as the CPUs if you have to put them in manually yourself. And I don't have that, so hopefully these are okay. I did the exact same thing I did with my other one, but hopefully they aren't over torqued. I can kinda see the thermal paste coming down a little bit down there, wherever it is. Actually, it's right up there. You can see it up in there. So hopefully everything is situated nicely and we'll move on to CPU number two. All right, so let's see how bad I can butcher this side now. So let's start. It's a little harder here with that other fan here. Anyway, let's continue on and see what we do here. All right, coming out. Here we go. Big fat X. That's not the straightest line. Definitely not doing as good this time. All right, coming in like so. Up and over the hill. Down we go. Oh, yeah. Now, blast here. Blast here. Blast there. And the blast here. Okay, well, definitely worse than the other one, but hopefully, you know, we don't run into any issues. Okay, so I do have both coolers installed now. So there's a lot of fan ports happening on this motherboard. So if I do end up running into issues when I start testing and stuff like that, maybe I'll just throw a 120 millimeter fan over here to blow out through the middle here or something. You know, I can figure something else out, but right now, hopefully this does work. The only issue is this little heat sink that's happening here, but these should be sucking in and then blowing the hot air out each side. So we'll see what happens there. Next up, we have to install our RAM, and there is a lot of RAM to put in here. So as mentioned, this is 2666 RAM. It is Samsung. Now you could go up to 3200, which is good for a random X and stuff like that. Most of the algorithms don't require very fast RAM or low latency, but random X does. And it is not probably worth the price. You may gain an extra couple kilohash. Yes, we're dealing with kilohash when you're dealing with so many cores and threads here by upping it, but it's gonna cost you a few hundred dollars more. So I really don't think it's worth it going to the 3200. But again, you know, if you're rich, it probably don't matter. So as most of you are aware, with DDR4 RAM, one side is longer and one side is shorter. So usually, always double check to make sure, but when it came to these EPYCs, I did find that the label pointing towards the CPU is the best way to go. Now, usually you take the brand on DDR4 with like your normal Ryzen consumer grades and stick the brand facing out. But with this, you take that little sticky tape label there and face it towards the CPUs, and that should fit all the slots evenly. Okay, so all the RAM is now installed. As you can see, four on this side, four on this side for each of those, and then four and four. So that's a total of 8 sticks of RAM per CPU, 16 sticks total. Now there's 16 gigabytes in each stick. So that's a total of 256 megabytes of memory here. Now, when it comes to CPU mining, remember, it's not about the amount of memory that you have, more that you have the channels all used up. And in this case, the EPYCs do have 8 channels. So you need all the slots filled up to utilize 8 channels, and RandomX just loves that. So next, we are going to need power. As you can see, there's a 24 pin and 2 8 pins for the CPU. I'm assuming this 8 pin is for that CPU and that 8 pin for that CPU. All right, so I do have power hooked up. I actually don't have my power supply ordered for this rig in yet. So I stole the 1000 watt from my other single 7742 EPYC. So I borrowed the power supply from the other EPYC and I used the 750 watt over there. So that should cover that. It was around 336 watts or something. So we're good on that end. So I have been testing this for a little while now. And as you can see, things are different from when we hooked this up and kind of built this earlier already. So I switched them around. So I'm gonna tell you what's going on here. Here you can see I got that fan blowing onto it as well. So I was running into CPU VRAM issues. So what I did is I tried it the way we previously had it. I had a bunch of fans sitting on top. I had little mini 120 millimeter fans here blowing in there. Nothing was working. It was beginning to overheat. So I'm like, uh-oh. So I then swapped this one around only first and left this one still with the fan in this way, and it was still overheating. That wouldn't work. So now I have them going this way. So the fan's blowing here, fan's blowing here. There is a lot more space in here at this point. And then hopefully I was able to put some fans here, and that was still not working. Eventually I did this. I put that AC Infinity fan in here. It's on setting about 5, blown into here. So now our CPU VRAMs is hanging out at about 76, 77 Celsius there. So it's staying within cool. Now the first time I didn't have any fans on here when I fired it up, and it started beeping and red lights were going off, and it like overheated and like 5 minutes. I'm like, oh my gosh, what is going on? I blew this thing up already. Things are going crazy. I had no idea what was going on. I found out, okay, that was the VRAM. So I tried a whole bunch of different settings here. I'm pretty much at a thermal paste now. Remember this guy here? Yeah, look at him. He's like almost gone. So I used up almost this whole tube, and it was a pretty exciting and crazy day. But so far, this is keeping everything, I guess, kind of cool for now. Also, I just blew the breaker down here, so I have a bunch of my rigs and my workstation stuff shut off. So we're burning up a lot of power here right now. I blew the breaker. Things are crazy, but the build is done, and I'm gonna have to figure out some other ways to kind of keep this thing cool, because I can't just pull that thing around everywhere. You know, maybe I need a different motherboard. Maybe I need a little bit of faster. I believe my fans, I was using the 120 mils. They were only like 1500 RPM. So maybe one of those industrial Noctua 3000s might work for this situated right here and blowing. You know, still a lot of things I got to figure out here, but right now this is mining. We'll look at hash rates and stuff in a different video, but things right now are currently working. Thank you for checking out this video. I will see you on the next one. Rabid out.